Hello students, welcome to my second video. In my first video, I hope you have seen and learned sentences and type of sentences. Now here, I am going to teach you question tags. Question tags fall under the category of interrogative sentences that we did in the first video about in the types. Interrogative sentences. So, what we see here, question tags are the questions that are used for asking confirmation said in the statement. Just for confirming the thing, we use these question tags. Let me give you one example here. Suppose a statement is made, he is a good boy. Now, this is just a statement. To make it into a question, I'll add a tag to it for reconfirming the thing said here. He is a good boy. Isn't he? So this part of the sentence is called the question tag, and this is the statement made by someone and the tag is used for confirming the thing here. So that kind of statement, that this kind of sentences are called interrogative, and this part is called the question tags. Now we have many rules for deciding what kind of tags we will use in the different kind of statements. So let's begin with the rules now. The first and the foremost rule for deciding on the question tags is, number one, that is, a positive statement will always have a negative tag. You must remember, and it's easy to remember also because it's always opposite. Positive will have negative question tag. Let us see, like this example given here is also the same kind. This is a positive statement, the tag is negative. I'll give you another example here. Like a statement is made, Tom likes dancing. Tom likes dancing. The tag will be, doesn't he? Tom here is a proper noun used. For its place, we have used a pronoun he. We have to decide if it is a girl, it will become she. If it is a boy, it will become he. So we know Tom has to be he. So we use a pronoun in place of it as he. And this becomes negative here. Now, how do we decide whether does or do or don't we will use? Now, here this is a positive verb, first in the simple present tense form. So, with that, we will use does. Why does? Because the third person singular has to be does here and the pronoun is used. So, this is the first rule. Second rule is just the opposite of this and easier to remember again. A negative statement will have a positive tag. I hope it's clear to you, these two at least. It's just related to each other. You have to remember, a negative, a positive statement, negative tag. A negative statement, positive tag. Now, a negative statement, suppose if I say, he doesn't like me. For this, the tag will be does, because it has to be positive. Does he? Question mark. So this is the positive tag with the negative statement. This you have to remember nicely. These are the most important part of it. Next we will see the other kind of sentences where the beginning is different or there are other statements also. How to add tags to those kind of sentences. Now, here only I'll tell you the third rule, which is like if the sentence is made about I, sometimes we need confirmation for ourselves as well. Like I am a fast runner. I am a fast runner. Now in that case, we will write, aren't I? This am is taking the place negative, we have to add since this is positive. I will not write am not I, that is incorrect. We will write down aren't I. Same if I write here a negative statement with I, like I don't get tired easily. Since this is a negative statement, it will have a positive tag. I don't get tired easily. Here I will add do I. Don't will become do and I will be written as I. So this you have to remember. These kind of statements are also there sometimes said about ourselves, where we have to add tags in this order. Like, so this is the third rule which we have to remember. Now let us see the fourth rule. Let us see now the fourth rule. Some statements are made in such this way also. Let's go out. But now the situation, we must not go out. It's just an example given here. Let's go out. The tag will be shall we. Shall we. Let's means let us. So here, this kind of statement, we will always have shall. There won't be any other helping verb. It will be shall and we, because let's means only that people, there are more than one people, and that also among ourselves something is said. So that is the fourth rule. Let us see the fifth rule. Fifth rule, like imperative sentences are there at times where we can add question tags, like open the windows. Will you? This kind of tag is always there in imperative statements. Whatever the statement is made, because we know there is no subject here in this kind of statement, it is considered to be you. Sentence is said to you, so we make use of will you here always in any kind of statement made which is an imperative statement sentence. Now the last rule, let us see, that is about having haves and do's. Haves and do's in a sentence means the helping verbs like haves and do's and be, if they are there in the helping verb, what kind of changes we will make. Like suppose it is he was tired. This is simple past form of the be form verb. He was tired. The tag will be wasn't he. If I use here he didn't complete his work. Did he? Now, suppose if the sentence is said in the simple present tense, like she sings very well. Then what are we going to add here as the tag? Sings, because simple present tense and she is a third person singular, so we will use here does, but since it is a positive statement, we will add here doesn't she, because we know this will be opposite here. Positive, it will be negative. Now next last rule is about sentences like anybody can join us. Anybody can join us. Can't they? this kind of sentences which are having indefinite pronoun, these are called indefinite pronoun, anybody, somebody, we don't know who these are. So in that kind of statements, we use, of course this is positive, so we will make negative here, and in place of anybody, we will write down they always. If it is anybody, somebody, nobody, whatever indefinite pronoun is used, we always use they for them. So these are the few rules that we need to remember while deciding on the question tags given in the exercises, and you must go through this video again and again to remember all these rules. And hope you will see the videos again and again and get the these rules by heart. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you all.